coordinate geometry. So in this topic we will see Cartesian coordinate system and coordinates, and then next we will see distance formula. So coming to the introduction point, we should have a first question in our mind: what is coordinate geometry? So basically, coordinate geometry, it is a system of geometry where the position of points on the plane is described using an ordered pair of number. Fine. So let's see their basic point one by one. So basically, to look at the position of a point on a plane, we require a pair of coordinate axes. The distance of a point from the y-axis is called x-coordinate. So basically, x-coordinate is called abscissa, and it is a distance from the y-axis. Similarly, y-coordinate is called ordinate, and it is a distance from the x-axis. So the coordinate of a point on the x-axis are of the form x, 0, and of the point on the y-axis are of the form 0, y. Fine. So now let's see the coordinate axis, which will help you to understand what is the meaning of the abscissa, ordinate, okay, and quadrant. Fine. So here we have two axes, x-axis and y-axis, and here we have origin, and in both the x and y-axis there are two sense. One is the positive sense, means positive direction, and one is negative direction. In positive direction we will plot the positive real number, and in negative sense we will plot the negative real number, and similarly for the y axis. Okay, so this is our quadrant system. So we have a four quadrant system: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. In first quadrant all are positive, means x and y both are positives. In second quadrant x will be negative, y will be positive, and in third quadrant both x and y will be negative. But in fourth quadrant x will be positives and y will be negative, and this is what origin. So let's try to understand the quadrant by taking some example. Suppose it's 2, 1. Since 2 and 1 both are positive, so we will plot on which quadrant? First quadrant. Similarly, -3, -2. This is all x is also negative, y is also negative. So we will plot on which quadrant? Third quadrant. So here, and that's what I told, that x coordinate is what called? It is called abscissa, and y coordinate is called what? Ordinate. Okay, and similarly we can plot any general point on this quadrant system. So can you say on which quadrant, if the point is lying on this completely on x-axis and completely on y-axis, which quadrant it will lie? So we will see this thing. So so this is our quadrant system, that's what I have explained. So suppose if a point is lying completely on what? Completely on x-axis or completely on y-axis, that point it will neither lie on any of the quadrant. So you should keep in mind. Okay, so let's take an illustration. So the question is in the figure. So the figure is they have given, if the area of the triangle AOB is 100 square units, okay, find the coordinates of A. So basically A, we have to find the coordinates of A, and which is lying on which axis? Y axis. So we can assume the coordinates on the y axis like 0, y, because on y axis we can take x coordinate always 0. Okay, so this is our triangle AOB, and in that triangle what they have given? In that triangle they have given area of this triangle is 100 square units. So can we find the area of the triangle? Yes, it is very easy to find. This triangle is what? Right angle triangle, and we know the area of the right angle triangle. Area of right angle triangle is half into base. Base is what? OB. Altitude is what? OA. So half into OB into OA. So half, and which is what they have given? which is they have given what? 100 square units. Okay, so half into OB is 10, OA is A. So half into 10 into A is 100. So if you will calculate 2 into it will go up in 5 times. So 5 divided 100 divided by 5. So it will come at what? 20. So what we got? We got that the coordinate of A is somewhat 0, 20. Okay. So now let's study the distance formula. In this section, we will see how to find the distance between the any two general points. So suppose this is point P x1, y1 and this is point Q x2, y2. This is our coordinate axis, coordinate or coordinate plane. This is our y axis, this is our x axis. So we are supposed to find the distance between the two points P and Q. Okay, so let's see how we can find it. So in order to find P and Q, so what we have done, we have drawn PR and QS perpendicular to what? X axis. Okay, similarly, and then what will happen? QS is drawn this to meet at the point T. Okay, to meet at the point T. So OR, what is this? OR it will be what? X1, this coordinate X1, abscissa. And OS will be what? X2, this coordinate. Okay, OR is X1, OS is X2. Similarly, PR equals to PS and it is equals to what? Y1. And QS it is equals to what? Y2. So can we find PT? Yes, we can find easily PT. PT will be what? Difference between the abscissa of this point and point P and point T. Fine. So this will be what? X2 minus X1. And similarly, we can find what? QT. QT will be what? Y2 minus Y1. I hope this point is clear. Okay. So now if we will apply the Pythagoras theorem on that triangle PTQ, we can write PQ square is what? PT square plus QT square. So H square is what? P square plus P square. So if then finally what we got? We will get a this root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Fine. And this is what the distance formula. Okay. So the so let's take an example based on the distance formula. Okay. Now the what the question is that find the distance between the point P 1 comma minus 3 and Q 5 comma 7. Fine. So let's see their solution. So we have to find the distance PQ. Okay, we have to find the distance PQ. So distance will be what? Root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So 5 minus 1 whole square plus 7 minus of minus 3 whole square. So 4 square 16 plus 100 square. So 100 square plus 16, it is what? Root under 116. So this will be what? 2 into root 29. So what does it mean? That the distance between A and B is what? 2 root 29. So now let's see the distance from the origin, and this formula is very important, please keep in mind. Okay, so the here we will see distance of P x comma y from the origin. So again we can use the distance formula here. So x2 minus x1 whole square. So here x1 and y1 both are 0. So x minus 0 whole square and plus y minus 0 whole square. So this will be what? Root of x square plus y square. So this is the distance from origin. So now let's see the application of distance formula. So basically the distance formula, it is used to check which type of triangle is formed by using three coordinates. Okay, and also this distance formula, it is also used to judge which type of quadrilateral is formed by using four coordinates. Okay, let's see. So suppose this is a quadrilateral. If opposite sides will be equal, and diagonals bisect each other, then what we will say? We will say that this is what? A parallelogram, because we know from the property of the parallelogram. Okay. Now let's see other example. So if we want to prove it is rhombus, the quadrilateral is rhombus. So what we need to do? We need to prove that all four sides will be what? Equal. Okay, na? So if all four sides will be equal, then we can say that the quadrilateral is what? Rhombus. Okay. So again, collinearity of three points. So here also we can prove by using distance formula, we can also prove that the three points are collinear. How? See, suppose this distance is A, this distance is B, and suppose this whole distance, this from this point to this point, okay, suppose this whole distance is what? C. And if C is A plus B, then we can say that these three points are collinear. So what is the meaning of collinearity of three points? Collinearity means all three points will lie on the same straight line. Okay, so if C equals to A plus B, we can say that all three points are lying on the same straight line. Okay, so today students, we have covered our two topics, which are those. First one is Cartesian coordinate system, and then next, and also we have seen the quadrants, and then we have seen what? Distance formula. So in further classes we will see some further topics. Okay, thank you.